Instead of substituting just a number, occasionally we'll need to substitute an expression. Just as we can replace a variable with a number, we can also replace it with an expression. Whenever we substitute, it's important to remember putting parentheses around anything that's being substituted. In example 1, we say that y is equal to 5x minus 3. Since it's already been solved for y, we can take this value and plug it in for y in the second equation to get everything in terms of x. Remember that you need to put parentheses around that thing that you're putting in for y, or the variable. From here, we simply distribute and solve for x. Adding like terms, we get negative 26x plus 15 is equal to negative 11. Subtracting 15 from both sides, we get negative 26x is equal to negative 26. If we divide by a negative 26 on both sides, we get x is equal to 1. Now that we know what x is equal to, we could then take x and substitute it back into the original equation to find the value for y. So my original equation was y equals 5x minus 3. Take 1 and substitute it in for x. So y is equal to 5 times 1 minus 3. So y is equal to 5 minus 3, or 2. So my coordinate point is 1, 2. Notice I put x first, then y, and I write it as if it's a coordinate point, because remember, we're finding where two lines intersect on a graph. In example 2, we have a similar situation, only this time the second equation is solved for x. So I will take this value here, or expression, and plug it in for x into the first given equation. When I do this, I'll have 2 times 5y minus 22 minus 6y equals negative 24. From here, I'll just distribute and solve for y. Adding like terms, I get 4y minus 44 is equal to negative 24. Adding 44 to both sides, I now have 4y is equal to positive 20. Dividing by 4, I get y is equal to 5. From here, I take the original equation, right here and find x. X is equal to 5 times y. We know y to now be 5, so we can find x. X is equal to 25 minus 22, or x is equal to 3. From here, we can write the coordinate point with x first and then y to give us the point at which the lines intersect each other.